with the woman that had issue of blood. Remember I said that old brother Jairus had to have been a believer because he knew that his daughter was dying. He wanted Jesus to come to his house to heal his daughter. But look at this. While he was waiting, the Bible said a servant came up and told him, now your daughter is dead. So now, not only did he have to have the faith to believe that God can heal her, now he has to have the faith that God can resurrect her. Hallelujah. Come on and bless the Lord in this house of prayer. Hallelujah. The Bible said that when the servant came and told Jairus that his daughter was dead, Jesus told Jairus, said, believe. Just believe. Hallelujah. That's what we have to do. When doubt comes, when people come with that doubt and try to put that doubt on you, you have to cast that down and still believe. Hallelujah. Because remember, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Hallelujah. Now, they go to the house. The Bible said that everybody in the house, all the maids, everybody crying. They're wailing over the little girl because now she's dead. Hallelujah. The Bible said that Jesus walked in to the room by himself. Notice, by himself. You can't have doubt around you when you have a faith in God. Hallelujah. There's a little doubt can stop your blessing from coming. Hallelujah. So the Bible said Jesus walked in by himself. And he grabbed the daughter by the hand. And the Bible says that her spirit came back into her body. Hallelujah. But Jesus told the parents not to tell anyone that had happened. But what he did do, he ordered him to give her something to eat. Hallelujah. Go ahead and put your hands together and give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. It is my time. Hallelujah. How many of you can decree that tonight? That it is my time. I don't know about you, but I have been through hell and high water. Hallelujah. So I know it is my time. It is my time to do what? Walk into my season. Hallelujah. I remember some nights, hallelujah, thank God for my prayer partners. Thank God for all my prayer partners. My main prayer partner right there in the back. That's what right there in the back. Hallelujah. But I remember, God, I remember just being in my house by myself alone. Just having a pity party with myself. Dad always say, little Sally Walker sat on a saucer, Saturday to rise. Hallelujah. So I remember sitting in my office having a pity party with myself saying, Lord, why am I going through this? Lord, everybody being blessed but me. Lord, everybody getting a husband but me. Lord, everybody getting a new car but me. Lord, everybody getting a new house but me. And then he spoke to me and he said, it's not your time. Hallelujah. Because God had to work with me with being obedient first. Hallelujah. I had to be obedient. And I had to learn how to be faithful. Now, one of the things we have to remember, sometimes we ask God for things that we're not even ready for. We're not even ready for. I know me, I'm just going to be honest, I know me in church, I'm like, oh Lord, please let me hit the lottery. Lord, I promise if I hit it, I'm going to pay my tithe. You talk about 100-something million, and God said, I can't trust you to pay the tithe on a little 1,200. So how am I going to bless you with me? Okay? So we have to be real with ourselves. You know, we have to wait on our season. We have to wait till we get that confirmation from God. And only then when we get that confirmation from God, we are able to walk into our season. Pray my strength into the Lord.